to you with words from John Paul II. It's words that he said at the World Youth Day in Denver, Colorado. And he said to the young people, it's my final words to you. He said to the young people, my young pilgrims, Christ needs you to enlighten the world and to show it the path to life. The challenge is to make the church's yes to life concrete and effective. The struggle will be long, and it needs for each one of you, it needs each one of you in this long struggle. Place your intelligence, your talents, your enthusiasm, your compassion, and your fortitude at the service of life. At this stage of history, the liberating message of the gospel of life has been put into your hands. And the mission of proclaiming it to the ends of the earth is now passed into your generation. Like the great apostle Paul, you too must feel the urgency, the full urgency of this task. Woe to me if I do not evangelize the gospel of life. Indeed, woe to you if you do not succeed in defending life. Have no fear. The outcome of the battle for life is already decided. Even though the struggle goes on against great odds and with much suffering, do not be afraid to go onto the streets, into the public square, like the first apostles who preached Christ and the good news of salvation in the public squares of the cities and of the towns and the villages. This is no time to be ashamed of the gospel. It's the time to preach it from the rooftops. God bless you.
Let's hear it up one more time for Monsignor Reilly. I'm thinking an hour and a half of theology on tap, we've been doing so much content and challenging things to think about, so thank you very much.
To you with words from John Paul II. It's words that he said at the World Youth Day in Denver, Colorado. And he said to the young people, and it's my final words to you. He said to the young people, my young pilgrims, Christ needs you to enlighten the world and to show it the path to life. The challenge is to make the church's yes to life concrete and effective. The struggle will be long, and it needs for each one of you, it needs each one of you in this long struggle. Place your intelligence, your talents, your enthusiasm, your compassion, and your fortitude at the service of life. At this stage of history, the liberating message of the gospel of life has been put into your hands. And the mission of proclaiming it to the ends of the earth is now passed into your generation. Like the great apostle Paul, you too must feel the urgency, the full urgency of this task. Woe to me if I do not evangelize the gospel of life. Indeed, woe to you if you do not succeed in defending life. Have no fear. The outcome of the battle for life is already decided. Even though the struggle goes on against great odds and with much suffering, do not be afraid to go onto the streets, into the public square, like the first apostles who preached Christ and the good news of salvation in the public squares of the cities and of the towns and the villages. This is no time to be ashamed of the gospel. It's the time to preach it from the rooftops. God bless you.
Let's hear it up one more time for Monsignor Reilly. have the theology on tap reading, so much content and challenging things to think about. So thank you very much.